Welcome to heaven. I know. Most of us wait all year for this. We want to thank you all for being here. Good afternoon. My name is Jim Jenkins, and I'm going to be your MC for this afternoon. This is Kevin R. Blandford Memorial Pipe Band's 3rd annual Celtic Christmas. And I want to thank our soloist, Alexander Walker, for Highland Cathedral. It's just wonderful. I see that we also have been blessed with some Scottish weather, so that's all. It helps the pipes, so we're always glad to see that. Feel free to go out and enjoy it anytime you want to, too. You can do that. On behalf of the bands, allow me to express our joy in being able to welcome you into this community, a community of friendship, a community of celebration for the season, and most of all, a community of passion for all things piping. In that spirit of community, we do have a special guest with us this afternoon that I would like to recognize, Nick Alanese. Nick, are you here? Nick is Kevin's partner, and he has been with us at these concerts for the last almost 20 years now. It's been a long time. You know, these concerts are a testimony to the strength of Kevin's legacy, but Nick, we also want you to know that that strength and that legacy also belongs to you. And we just want you to know that the affection and respect that goes into the creation of these concerts and all the musicians that gather, that that respect and affection is also yours. Like the bass drum beating heart of these bands, it also belongs to you, and we are grateful for you and always honored to have you here. So welcome. Thank you. The conductor for our concert today is going to be Matthew Keating. He's the executive director at the Claremont Community School of Music and also a master cellist. You're going to hear him a little bit later as well on that instrument. Matthew has been an ardent supporter of the KRB Memorial Band all the way throughout the years as well. And of course, you've already heard what makes this concert very unique: the exhilarating combination of both brass, percussion, organ, and bagpipes, which I'm not sure you're going to hear too many other places. And we have Dr. Carey Robertson to thank for that. She is our organist. She's a clinician and an educator. She's also a concert organist. She's professor of organ at Claremont Graduate University and principal organist here at Claremont United Church of Christ. She also teaches music in the Fontana School District and has performed throughout the U.S., Canada, and abroad. Just a couple of reminders before we move on. There's no food or drink allowed in the sanctuary, please. And if right now you could take out those handy little personal computers that you call a phone and just switch them off. Our next tune is Joy to the World with our soloist, Martha Hall.
Thank you.
Thank you. Our soloist for Angels We Have Heard on High was Michael Tony Sewell, and our soloist for Amazing Grace was Larry Martinez. We are once again delighted to have the Claremont United Church of Christ Handbell Choir with us. They were with us last year as well. And I know it's always a treat to have them here. I would like to introduce each one of the members because I know they work very hard to do this on a regular basis, and we just love the fact that they've taken time out to come and share with us today. This choir consists of Hillary Lackey, Susan Laminska, Sandy Parker, Dick Sanders, yeah, Jane Robb, Heather Zvenitse, Jenny Teniek, Lee Wagner, and Bill Wagger. And let's have a big round of applause for them. Thank you. Yes. Welcome to you. And our piping duet is going to be played by Sean Keating and Daniel Croissant.
Thank you.
was fantastic. Thank you so much. Thank you for that. Before 30 minutes, it's gone fast. Seriously, we're already at the end of Act One, but before we actually get to that last tune, I would like to introduce the other musicians who are making this incredible and unique sound possible today. First, our brass section. We have Josh Welchez, Peter Adam, Mark Kobayashi, sorry about that, Robert Creek, and Joseph Jackson. It's our brass. They're all very shy. On timpani, we have Scott Smith. And on cymbals, chimes, and the all-important sleigh bells, we have Jeff Brown. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you. This last tune that ends our Act One, Fanfare and O Come All You Faithful, our soloist is Tyler Anderson. And that's only half of it. I know, it's exciting. Again, I really want to thank our brass and percussionists. They have just done an amazing job today. Thank you so much, you guys. Matthew and Dr. Robinson will be back towards the end of the second act, but as you go into the foyer, you have a 15-minute break to do what you need to do. Go out and enjoy the sunshine. We'll give you a warning before it's time to go back. But while you're out there, take a look at some of the merchandise that we have, KRB merchandise, including new this year, some Christmas tree ornaments. And if you like the music, yes, there are CDs. Also, you know, consider making, you know, if you have the means, consider making a contribution to the bands. They're going to be headed back to the World's Championships in 2024 in Glasgow. And, you know, the last time they were there, grade three won sixth place. Yes. My wife and I were standing on Glasgow Green underneath that sign, place one, place two, and then place six. Oh, it was such a great day. And they're going back because they still have business to take care of in Glasgow. So they really need your help with their travel and their competition expenses. So think about that. So go ahead, take a break, relax, stretch your ears and your legs, and we'll see you back here in 15 minutes. Welcome back, everyone. Hope you enjoyed a little time off. As we move into Act Two, you're going to see a larger diversity of bands and musicians up here. And of course, we have our Highland dancers coming up too, so be excited to see that. This next tune is called Bonnie Dundee. It's a 6/8 march. It's played by our grade 3 and 4 bands, some including Upland and Glendora High alums, and current students from Upland High School Pipe Band. Yes. We'll be talking a little bit more about them in a little bit, too. So, the pipe majors are Larry Martinez for the grade 4 band, Alexander Walker for grade 3 band, and led by our drum major, Greg Rochford. Greg Rochford, ladies and gentlemen.
Connor.
For our Highland dance set, it's a real pleasure to bring back our Highland dancers who've been dancing actually with the band for several years, but this is their second appearance for Celtic Christmas. And it's always a pleasure to have them. They're from the Armstrong School of Dance in San Diego. And for this particular tune, two of the trio, Weston and Colton Kraus, will be dancing for us. Let's give them a hand.
Thank you.
The Kraus brothers are going to be joined by their sister a little bit later in the program, too, so we'll be seeing her. As you've noticed in the program, we have drummers and pipers that work with the band and also play with the band from two high school programs this afternoon, Upland and Glendora High School. Oh, I thought I was going to hear somebody yip. Well, I figured there was at least one Upland alumnus and one Glendora. Yeah, okay, there we go. There's a couple of you out there. Anyway, so, yeah, rah-rah. In fact, several of the Blandford Band pipers and drummers actually are alumni of these two high school programs. This next set features current and former students from the Upland High School Pipe Band program. The program is directed by Ernie Miranda and Mark Capalbo, under the instruction of world-class piper Seamus Coyne and Blandford Band members themselves. This program is slowly being rebuilt, with the plan to have them compete at the Las Vegas Highland Games this next year, and I'm not sure if they know it or not, and head to Glasgow for the World Championships in 2025 in the juvenile division. Yeah. And I know that 2 years seems like a long time to prep, not for the world, so they got a lot of work ahead of them. The UHS Pipe Band currently gets significant performance experience at school events, Scottish festivals, and many other events in the community and throughout the region. They are able to take advantage of exemplary additional learning opportunities through scholarships to the Rob McClintock California School of Piping and Drumming. This next tune features Andrew Van Dorp, a former UHS pipe major and College of Piping scholarship recipient. Drum Sergeant Guadalupe Alemán. On tenor drum, Andrew Kopal on snare drum. And Ireland Rosa on bass drum. Already going to buy my tickets to Glasgow. It's going to be wonderful to see them there. The second high school band, pipe band program that's also being featured today is from Glendora High School. That's what I'm talking about. I personally am a Wolfpack Claremont High School graduate. Yes, well, anyways, We can talk about that later. This program has actually been going in some form since the mid-1950s, but actually has been competing actively since 2002. They've competed in aggregate grades 3 and 4, and have solo competition, and have also competed in solo competitions at the Queen Mary, Costa Mesa, Las Vegas, and even won in aggregate grade 4 contests. So this is one of the bands that even when the older bands see them, they fear them. I was going to use the word wipe in some connection, but I didn't want to do that. For many of these students, it's not uncommon in such programs as this, pipes or drums are not the only instruments they play. Many of them also play secondary instruments in other school bands, including marching bands, which have their own often strenuous performance and competition schedules. Instructed by Jennifer DeBar and Alex Bischke, led by pipe major Ivana Brandvika and drum sergeant Daniel Acosta, here's the Glendora High School Pipe Band with Anthony Mardoyan filling in for Ivana, playing the Welsh Dragons and the Eavesdropper. Well-deserved reputation. That set highlighted our grade three drum corps. Fantastic. Drum Sergeant Carl McIntyre, Pipe Major Alexander Walker. As we set up for our next medley, yes, you see a drum set being set up for our next medley. So fasten your seatbelts first. I'd like to thank some very special people who have made this day possible and are always there for us when it's time to be able to give to you a treat like this at any time of the year. First of all, I would like once again to thank Matthew Keating, our conductor, and Dr. Carey Robertson, our organist. And they will be back. I'd also like to thank a couple of newbies, and I'm sure they're not even in here right now because they're out herding people around. Heather Reynolds and Doris Lynn are our stage managers. They've been, yes, absolutely. The picture in the program tells you everything you need to know about Heather and Doris. They're longtime supporters. I'll take you a second to get there. It's on the back page, towards the back. Never mind. They've been longtime fans and supporters of the bands, but this is their first time working behind the scenes, and they've done a fantastic job to make an event like this seem as seamless as it does. Of course, we thank the Claremont United Church of Christ for this absolutely fantastic space and the organ that has 4,031 pipes. It's the fifth largest organ in the world, just so, yeah, I know. And it's been used to being played along with bagpipes, so I think that's just a fantastic thing. Claremont Community School of Music, they've always been there for us too. We really thank them. Davey Armstrong, who was the original designer of our KRB logos, everything that you see on all of our merchandise, that was designed by him. Brady Inc. T-shirts, who of course does our T-shirts, and as soon as they get a 4X in stock, I'm there. Yeah. We also want to thank the Upland High School Music Department for their percussion equipment. That's always great too. We have so many volunteers. There's so many that we can't even name, but you see them around here doing everything, including the people that are in front of the sanctuary. They're always there for us too, and without them we could not make this work. I also want to say hello to those of you who are streaming with us live. Thank you so much for connecting with us. Next time you should be here because it's even much better in person. So, but we do thank you for joining us. Yes, absolutely. Are we going to applaud those streaming? Yeah, you can do that. Don't say we don't appreciate you, because we do. This next set of one hornpipe and two jigs also features our talented friend Alistair Mitchell on drums, as well as the third member of the Kraus Trio, Ailey Kraus.
Thank you. Ailey Kraus.
Thank you, Ailey. And Alistair Mitchell on drums. Of course, we had Tyler, Martha, Daniel, Alex, and Tony piping. So, but yeah. Because that's what they do. Just a couple of reminders as we set up for one of our last sets in this act. You can follow the band on Instagram. All this is in your program. You can follow them on Twitter. Blandfordbands.org is their webpage. And we encourage you to go there. Keep track of their schedule. You can go. One of the most fun days you could have, trust me, is to go out on a Saturday or a Sunday, find the beer tent or the water tent. They're right next to each other, and sit and listen to a whole day or two of piping. It's fantastic. It's actually a real pleasure to be able to introduce one of the favorite parts, at least for me, of these concerts, but I know for a lot of people that I've talked to. Not only because these three musicians are siblings, and not only because they're ardent supporters of the Blandford bands, but the sound that they produce together is just as exquisite as it is unique. Please welcome Sean Keating on the uilleann pipes, Mary Keating on the fiddle, and Matthew Keating on the cello. Thank you.
the Scottish weather today.
Thank you.
I think we're going over to the Keating's house after the show, right? I'm going to continue the party there. Thank you both. Thank you so much. Well, as we move into our finale, just again want to say thank you for joining us. I hope today has been a day where you've maybe been uplifted a little bit, where you've maybe forgotten about some of the bad things that might be happening, that your heart is both full and lightened, and that you walk out of this place with joy, because that's been our desire today, is to help you move to maybe a little bit higher plane than when you walked in. It's been a great joy to be able to bring this music to you today. And just a reminder, put us on your calendars for next year, December 10th. We'll be back. Bring your friends. It's a great Christmas gift for someone, as you know. So we just want to say thank you again and enjoy the finale. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Have a safe, peaceful, and joyous holiday, and drive safely out there. We'll see you next year. Bye-bye.
I am. 73.
Oh, so, okay, so my brother was 74 or 75. So you were there, you were a freshman?